Hi, everybody. It's such a great crowd. So sometimes when I tell a little bit about my story, it makes me feel very sleepy and sad, and just like as I go back through it in my head, even just like, ugh. But this is my favorite place to talk about me and Lyme because it is all about progress and about science and about hope. And I'm really proud of everything that's happened here, and I'm really thankful, and I want to thank everybody who's worked on this. It's amazing what we've done. It's just So I know there's a lot of people that are Lyme patients here. Actually, I'd love to know how many. Could you raise your hand if you're, oh, wow, okay. Oh, me too, yeah. All right. And I'm sure you're probably all at different stages of your journey, maybe we'll call it a journey, and have probably heard what I hear sometimes now, which is, so are you better now? You look great. Like, well, I'm a lot better now, and I don't know for sure. There's so many unknowns that are really frustrating, and that is one of the reasons we got really excited about bringing science into this, because you know, the public policy elements, all of the emails you get, the anger and frustration that are out there, all of that is real and valid, but it's hard to find hope in that or engage with it, really. So it was a cool thing for us to be able to kind of go around that and find a different way into this. And in the meantime, after many, many years of treatment, I am actually much better, which is awesome. But I'm still, like, I'm better with trepidation, I guess, because I don't know what's going to happen. And I'm thankful for all of it, but it would be great to be able to know for sure what's actually going on inside of all of our bodies. You know, are we still actively infected? Do we have a rheumatological problem? What's really happening? And what makes weird flare-ups happen? And how do we handle that or talk about it? So, is that enough? Is that enough? All right, I'm gonna let Jeff talk for a minute.
Well, very briefly, I went through this journey, and I'm still going through it, but went through this journey with Liesl, and as those of you who are supporters, caregivers, friends, and family of Lyme sufferers, it's quite an emotional experience to have somebody that you care about so deeply suffer so terribly and not be able to help them. My background is science and engineering. I never could have been employed as a scientist or engineer by ISB, unfortunately, so I ended up in business. I work at Amazon. I work with some amazing computer scientists. And when Liesl was really struggling the most, my instinct was, as is the case anytime I encounter incredible suffering, is to think of the antidote that seems to work really well, which is science. And so we sought out science for this suffering. And through Susan, we were introduced to Lee, and I read a little bit about his background and the trajectory that was moving toward this marriage of computer science and biology. And because I knew something about the computer science side and big data and all the things that we could do with these tools that were evolving, I was really optimistic that they were onto something that really could help in complicated systems-related disease. So we met with Lee, and as anyone who's met with Lee for the first time can attest to, it was incredibly compelling. I was hooked right away. And he did what any good scientist would do, which is instead of saying, you know, yes, I like what you have to say, let's get started, he said, let me study the problem. So fortunately, he didn't study it for too long, but he assembled an amazing collection of world-class scientists from all sides, you know, sort of this. Unfortunately, there's a debate in this Lyme realm, which seems crazy to me because what we really care about is the patients. But he assembled people from all of the different points of view, and we convened a conference here in this room, and very quickly I became even more optimistic. The science trajectories that were possible seemed really, really interesting, and Lee committed to throwing everything ISB had at this. So I'm really impressed with the work that the team here has done over the last 4 years. There's so much more to do, as you know. But again, I can't think of a better antidote to suffering than science, and I'm incredibly happy for Liesl and for all of you that ISB is on it.